Yeah.
Let the riff rip, I'm in cap, yeah. Feeling like Rip King. No hoes on a cap, but we chillin'. Hella hoes in the back, I'm finessing. Till she reach the climax, vibing, riding, smoking, writing. Illuminating my
life.
It
takes to get ready.
Learning to create my own life. Look,
scary.
Remove the strike. This life we live. It's so beautiful. The love surrounding me. It's so
bad. I'm just gonna start filming, but I don't care that you're there. My journey far from finished. Focus on the camera. Okay. Leading to the rainbow. Hi guys, so welcome back. I know it's been a while since I last filmed. I'm at my friend Maddie's beautiful house. This is gonna be the third part of the inauguration series, which I know is like super old news now, but I still feel like I got some cool stuff that I wanna share with you anyways. So I'm just gonna get right into it. I don't know how much I'm gonna actually explain or do any sort of commentary on this. It's more just be like the visual of what happened on the day, and then I want to check in on what's going on now versus where we were then. Okay, hi.
I think you know this
one. Hold on, hey, you know, this is getting interpreted as something bad. You need to come out and say something.
Donald Trump, go away. Racist, sexist, anti-gay. Donald Trump, go away. Racist, sexist, anti-gay.
Bring some of those tax returns with you.
I love
you. Thank you.
We don't cross, we don't go across. Go over to the front and let the soldiers know they go across.
This is also like ridiculous because these are people just trying to get across the other side. Is the parade in here?
Only meeting has bags. I think you know I caught up because we had a lot going on.
Thank you. Okay, so I'm going into the parade by myself. Because Tuesday couldn't get in with her backpack, so here we go. So now we move into my secret stealthy camera portion of the vlog. So yeah, at the parade, I was basically surrounded by all Trump supporters. I just thought they'd be a little bit more honest if they didn't know there was a camera filming them. This was all kind of secret detective work. So some of the footage is pointed toward the ground or pointed at someone's shirt or someone's back or something. That is because I was doing it in secret.
So is this the street where the parade's gonna be?
This is it, yeah.
Okay, great.
Two relatives. All right, let me call you guys this parade story. Okay, all right, see you.
Trump's coming.
I'm going to.
You know what that was? PA down there. I didn't see one up here.
Charleston, South Carolina.
I don't even have any idea what goes on in one of these parades. Motor cars, dancers, who knows?
They talked a lot about you. They said whether you're black, brown, white, we all bleed. The red blood of the patriot, you know. And I heard his cabinet member saying that last week or so, talking about that he's insisting that they now work for the people.
Well, I had a friend who worked in the closed this whole area off, this whole like big area.
Maybe that's what everybody was looking at yesterday when we were walking by.
I've never come again if I didn't have cigarettes. Like, we stood in line for, like, miles.
We watched the whole thing in a bar.
They got up at 4. And shit, they had cigarettes.
She wanted to come at 6.
Okay.
And I didn't make it at 6.
We should have came at 6.
But we were 7:30.
7:30?
And it was already packed.
Really?
Yeah. The Uber guy couldn't even get us close enough.
Oh, yeah. I was going to say, I have snacks, too. I have trail mix. You guys want trail mix?
I want trail mix. 100. Yeah, I'm not going to say no. I was curious about that. Because at the election, like, night when he spoke about him, he spoke about him so highly, like, as if he must have done, like,
everything, and I was wondering what that meant.
Just brilliant. He pulled together all his rich Silicon Valley friends, and they started analyzing data and figuring out how to get to all the people they needed to. And they changed all the campaigning the last 2-3 weeks of the campaign. They knew exactly where they had to go. People on the Fox are saying, what the hell is he doing so much in Pennsylvania? Why is he over there? Why is he here?
Yeah.
Well, they knew what they were doing.
Do you have any insight, all conventional wisdom, like campaigning and stuff? Like,
yeah, that's absurd. Like,
very data-driven, everything they did. And like, he spent, what, a fourth of what Hillary spent?
Yeah.
Or less than a fourth?
Yep, he's heading to the limo down the steps.
We have our live feed.
Okay, finally heading down the steps to the limo. That was 2 minutes ago.
But there's 89,000 steps, so it'll be a while. He's scaling it. He's on a rope coming down the hill.
Oh, God.
He has a grappling hook just rappelling down.
He's got a nice looking family.
He's got their great. Yes, he does. I'm so glad Baron was there.
Yeah, why didn't Baron show up? What happened? Everyone keeps it. My sister keeps asking me.
You know, I keep thinking maybe it's too much on. I'm 10 years old. She's getting
the
light.
Election night. He looked like he was going to fall asleep on that stage. No. Poor thing.
I think it just scared him, maybe.
You know what? Maybe after all that Rosie O'Donnell stuff, maybe they didn't want him to miss
them. He was bullied.
Oh, he was bullied. Yeah, so maybe they thought, let's just see if
he right, let him leave. He promised that I don't want to go.
Yeah. Oh, sure. Yes, they said, okay.
What happened? I didn't hear about it.
Like last night and the last few days, he's just
oh, yeah. But who bullied him? Rosie O'Donnell?
Rosie O'Donnell did, yeah. Oh, she's such a bully anyway. And who's she to talk to? The child that she adopted doesn't even have anything to do with her.
I know.
Right?
Right.
They're in the car heading to the parade.
Oh, there it is. Yeah.
There's Ivanka heading in 3 minutes
oh,
ago.
Oh, it's his
sparrow?
No, that's her son, right? Whose little kid's that?
That's hers. Ivanka has three.
I think I should.
Oh, there's Ivanka, right?
It was a riot. So Obama was speaking, they were just like, get off, get off, get off, go. Yeah, it's amazing. It truly is just one in a lifetime. It's just... Yeah, but actually we didn't see him because they were all over at the mall, so they were trying to keep the protesters off from that side. We're now gated off on Pennsylvania 12, but there's rioters just outside our gate. They've already broke the windows, they set flags on fire, they took people's Trump flags. Yeah, it's been really, it's been bad. But that was really, I didn't see anything over at the inauguration all day. 200,000 phones.
And in front of the camera now, so you don't have to bring your own little like point and shoot camera. It's all in here.
Wouldn't it be neat if it was all under one, like everybody knew where to go to?
Yeah, that would
swap
be cool.
Those pictures and add them.
Facebook.
I wonder if they have a hashtag for this weekend. I'm sure they do, and you just go to the hashtag and you post all your things to the hashtag and then find it. I'm sure they have to. I bet.
Oh, something's happening.
All right, just keep watching one. You'll be able to see it.
Okay, Commander Raz, I see you!
Secret Service, they protect the president. There's the presidential limo.
That was crazy. Wow. That was insane. I just saw Donald Trump, President Trump, walk probably like 15 feet in front of me. Okay. This is happening. This happened. I basically snuck into the, well, didn't sneak in. I'm allowed. I'm an American, but Played it cool, said I was a journalist from Ohio State. I got to talk to some pretty staunch Republicans about stuff, but it was very eye-opening and weird and awesome and scary too. Walking through the aftermath, supposedly when I was in there, protesters were setting flags on fire. 90 protesters have already been arrested. Breaking through windows, there was tear gas.
Police are standing their ground, standing their line with batons in hand. More than 217 protesters arrested, 6 police officers injured, David.
I don't know, me and Tuesday got separated. It's been really intense. Everyone's heading back. City is clearing out, just stragglers. Heading back in this new America. Such a long, such a crazy day, but we made it and I'm so tired. It's crazy. I think we probably walked like the day before we walked 12 miles. So today I probably walked like close to 15 or something insane, but we are starving. We're about to make some spring rolls and some pho, vegan pho, and then sit and unload footage and stretch and just digest what happened all day. It's pretty crazy, so I will check back in after we cook.
Let the rip, I'm in cap, yeah. Feeling like Rip King. No hoes on a cap, but we chilling.
I'm just gonna be fat. It's gonna be way too fat. I fucked up. I put so much rice.
No, I think
I'm not very good at this.
I'm finessing till she reached the climax.
Mo is bon smoking. Right,
no sushi for you, Mo.
No sushi for you.
Ah, this one is so much better. Oh, this one is real sushi. I'm gonna eat it again. Okay, so we just made vegan, what would you call these? Fresh rolls? Seaweed and just rice paper. Seriously, you guys? I'm freaking out. Like, they're one of the most delicious things I've ever had in my life. How do you feel? The same?
Yeah, definitely.
Mm-hmm. So good.
Till she reached the climax, yeah. Vibing, writing, smoking, writing. Yeah. Illuminating my life. Learning to create my own life. Look. Yeah. Remove the stripe. Yeah. This light.
No, why does it do that?
No.
It's so annoying. All right, so we are clean and ready to eat this delicious feast. It was a really crazy day. We saw a lot of intense things. A lot of beautiful things, but also a lot of very, like, I don't know, troubling things. I did talk to a bunch of individuals from each, like, side. And most of all, what I got out today is, like, everyone just wants a better life for themselves and the people that they love. I think what's missing is like the humanity, right? So like not only should you care about yourself and the people that you love in your immediate circle, but like everyone. in the United States and everyone in the world, we could broaden that scope that might help with on both sides. Like, I honestly was really surprised by the, I don't know, I felt it was like the disregard for human decency from the liberal camp today. But that's just, I was really surprised. Tactics that were being used were, in my opinion, and I know they were coming from like a place of like anger and frustration and fear and all that, but like, I don't know, like breaking windows and burning American flags doesn't really accomplish anything. That's my opinion. What do you feel?
I'm tired. And there's a lot of emotions to process.
What was the thing that surprised you the most?
Just seeing like young kids like supporting Trump and not really knowing why. And like, I don't know. That was weird, and just, I would have wanted to talk to the kid and be like, okay, so why Trump and what do you know? But I know they're just reiterating things their parents have told them, and that's concerning. Yeah, I agree that like the protesters on the other side are always aggressive and they come from a place of fear, and like, I get it. We felt forgotten and put on the other side for a long time, and now...
Yeah, and now it's switched.
And now it's switched, and like we're the majority.
The pendulum has swung.
Like the weird people are the majorities now, or like the liberals are the majority, and like, okay, it's different, but we don't believe that people should sign up for a list.
There's a lot of emotions. There's a lot to process.
It's a ton.
So we're gonna stop focusing on this for a while and just eat and then go to bed and relax. So yeah. That's all for tonight. We have the march in the morning, so we'll be getting up early to do the Million Women March on Washington, and I'm very excited for that, and I'm sure we're going to have just another packed day. So, yeah. Good night. Good night.
Night.
You guys are crying bitches that you lost, right?
Yeah, pretty
much. Is that what it is?
Okay,
yeah.
Just check.
Can we get
some
help, please, sir?
Come on, man. Let the ladies through. Thank you.
Well, everybody. Fuck you and your roadblock, you piece of shit. Fuck him. Fucking do it again, bitch. Well, yeah, I'd be a big man with a fucking weapon too, huh? Let's go, bitch.
Hey, come on. You just hit a lady.
I don't give a fuck. You just hit a lady. You hit back.
You just hit a fucking woman.
She don't look like a woman to me.
Are you gonna arrest that motherfucker or what?
Back up.
He just punched a woman in the face.
All right,
you're not gonna arrest that piece of shit?
I have it on.
You're arresting him for standing up for her. And you're not gonna arrest him.
No, your guy's a good journalist. Fake news.
Look. Fake news.
Just do your job, man. I'm trying to engage.
Okay? You're okay.
You should be fucking ashamed. You should be ashamed. We are the workers. We make this society function, you piece of shit. You bourgeois fucking cunt.
Bourgeois and worker in the same sentence.
Suck my fucking cock! I'll piss on your grave, old man! Your fucking cronies is punched a woman, you fucking bitch!
We're here for the courthouse.
Can I speak to my comrade for a moment?
Back up. Can I speak to
him? I'm not gonna say again, back up.
Yeah. It's best not to.
Where? What? Wow, that happened really fast. Aw, come on, guys. Please don't arrest him.
We're leaving. Now. We can't help him until he calls us. He's gonna have to call us from jail for us to help him.
Okay. We might. You need medical attention?
He really didn't do anything. I got punched in the face. He was just trying to stop that.
She was punched in the face on the boat and he defended her. You can't arrest him. The guy who punched her in the face on the boat is still there. But you shouldn't arrest that guy for defending a woman being assaulted by a grown-ass man!
Come on,
that is not fucking law enforcement!
Do it! I already got punched in the face once.
Can you step back with me, please?
You're gonna arrest him for nothing? For defending a fucking woman from assault! You're going to arrest him!
for defending a woman from an unprovoked assault by a grown man, you're going to arrest him. That is the case. That is what's happening. Yes? Show me what a police state looks like!
This is right.
Show me what a police state looks like!
This is what a police state looks like!
Show me what a police state looks like!
This is what a police state looks like!
Show me what a police state looks like!
This is what a police state looks like!
Show me what a police state looks like!
This is what a police state looks like!
Show me what the police state looks like!
This is what a police state looks like!
Show me what the police state looks like!
This is what a police state looks like!
What a police state looks like! Fuck
you, bitch! Don't say anything, Tim.